So, Death Pierce used to be my absolute favorite character to throw in the back line for like probably the first 2 years of the game, up until people maybe figured out that you could throw Red Z or Festival Zeldris on pretty much anything. And then Ragnarok Bond kind of came out, so obviously he's a bit dated. I did just now level 100 him, I think it was yesterday, but if you don't know what he does, because a lot of people don't use him nowadays and you might be newer, he decreases all enemies' crit resistance and crit defense by 30%, so you can crit easier and your crits hit harder. So I don't think 30% is really all that crazy nowadays, but if we're using like the top, newest characters that have come out, their crit chance and crit resistance and stuff like that should all be around the same-ish. So hopefully it'll work out for me here, but obviously he is pretty old. I honestly think that the Roxy is pretty good overall. I think a lot of people are just going to get more PvE use out of her for the moment, but she just really can't compete too well against the current meta stuff because of how like much they synergize. I really honestly think that they either need to if AOT is right around the corner and somehow they end up coming up with a character from the AOT collab that will benefit the human team like really well, then that'll be great, of course. But the biggest thing is I think they just need to go back through and give some of the humans that still don't have holy relics a holy relic, because Death Pierce would be a fantastic unit to get a holy relic. He honestly needs some new outfits as well, like costumes, because a lot of his pieces are like SR pieces, which are like incredibly expensive to power up if you're using cosmetic materials and stuff like that. So there's just a lot of stuff that they could really do to kind of bring this team up a bit, which I don't think would be, the craziest thing in the world. Like I honestly think that she's not super like broken OP or anything. After, seeing a lot of the gameplay that the JP YouTubers were using, I don't know if they just cut out a lot of their like bad matches, or if they really are just like that far above me as far as like account CC and stuff like that goes, but she's not doing as good as I was expecting her to do in PvP, and I don't know. It's draining me a little bit, just like playing with Roxy over and over and over and over again, and just seeing how like the Angel team has so much support. Obviously, they still need a good backliner, but the Demon team just gets endless amounts of holy relics and new units and stuff like that. It's just. It's so draining to see like the human team, which honestly Escanor was like there wasn't really a human team before after Purgatory Bond basically got shot out of the meta. There wasn't really a good human team on the market. Escanor was basically like a lone wolf if I had to peg him as anything, and honestly it just it is what it is. I mean, you can kind of just throw him on a team with some good support, and he can kind of carry on his own, you know what I mean? So it's this might be a misplay, but it just kind of is what it is. The human team needs some better support. I know a lot of people right now are really wanting, Mael to get a good backline unit, which is understandable. A lot of people have been now invested into the Goddess team. Damn, they are so tanky. Maybe I should have went for Nanashi, I don't know. But yeah, I don't know. There's just it falls short a lot of the time. Like you can see how easily it is to get rid of Roxy. If I didn't have that evasion food on, this has happened to me like 3 times today. I don't know what's going on. Hopefully that keeps me in. But either way, there's just so much that needs to be done. There's so many teams that would be really fun to play. Maybe the game is just in a weird spot because it did that to me earlier. Maybe he got the same thing. I'm not 100% sure on that. But either way, let's hop into a couple more. I'm basically gonna continue to play ungeared for now, because in geared, there's almost no chance she survives if you don't go first. And even then, you're gonna one-shot one character basically with him or with her and Escanor, and then the team kind of falls apart depending on your card draw. That just there's not a good backliner unit for this team. I mean, like you could just throw Ragnarok Bond on, of course, and everything, but his CC is not the greatest. You're gonna have to run this character on pretty much attack crit damage if you want her to do like the big damage that you're expecting. So that's also gonna kind of stunt you a little bit there as well. I don't know. There's just a couple of weird things that end up being kind of annoying about running this team, which it is what it is. Not every team can be, like, competitive and, you know, whatever. But one of the biggest things that people want in this game is to be able to use older units and actually compete. Or not necessarily compete, but just have them survive and have fun in PvP and still have a chance to win. You don't have to have, like... I don't think people are asking for, like, old units to absolutely dominate the meta or anything, but that's unfortunate. This is going to get... Wait. Did it not go off? What happened there? I don't know what happened there, but either way, I don't know. I genuinely think that the human team would be really nice. Honestly, you want as many teams to be able to compete in the meta as you possibly can, because then there's going to be more variety, more fun. It's not just going to be like, hey, here's another riveting match of demons versus, you know, angels, which is, you know, you've seen that a billion times in the past month or so. Or even then, I mean, the demons have so much support that a lot of people are just running just demons. There's not really any reason for people to run angels at the moment. So people are just running, you know, tons of demon teams because they're getting relics, they're getting support, they're getting everything that they need to continue to be the top meta. And it's just, phew, it kind of sucks, man. It's really bogging me down, I have to say. Let me use, just in case we can kill the Echidna here, which I don't know if we can with these cards. I don't want to seal my Escanor if I don't have to. It's probably not going to work out too well. This AoE doesn't really do that great. Yeah. I don't know, man. She's, her AoE kind of blows. There's not a whole lot of great characters to run her with at the moment. It's just... There's just a conundrum that you're in, really. I'm really glad that she works in PvE stuff. The fact that she's, like, so good to bypass the damage caps and stuff like that in, like, Demonic Beast battles and stuff. And I can't wait for a final boss, actually, to come back. So that way she can hopefully get through, you know, the damage caps on those if they end up doing newer ones. Because most of the newer ones end up having, damage caps on them. So, I don't know, it's just one of those things. I'm glad she has multiple uses, but for PvP-wise, unless you're like a big whale, you already have her 6-6, which I think is another issue that she has, where if you don't have her like completely maxed out, you're going to be missing out on the extra attack-related stats that she gets from her Unity, which is also really annoying. Like, why not just have it like a regular Grace where you can throw it on somebody? Why tie everything to the ultimate level? It's so stupid. Like, I get it. I know why they're doing it. It's money, but man, you got to do so much stuff to characters in this game. Why make everything rely on an ultimate level? I don't know. Maybe I'm just venting a little bit here. Might get annoying, but Deathpierce is really cool. I don't know that you can really even tell that he's helping at all, because she's basically going to hit every crit ever. And, I mean, honestly, I think Escanor's hitting a little bit more consistent crits, but obviously against newer characters, it might be a little bit less consistent, but I don't know. Next match. Alrighty, we have an Escanor here. I'm kind of glad we're not going up against too many Angel teams, because they obviously can't be lowered. Like, I know Escanor can't be lowered, so we should have a pretty decent time here getting through, these characters. But, you know, that's another thing. They've made it to where every single character nowadays is just, like, immune to stat lowering, like, crazy. Like, if you don't do something, they're gonna do something. Like, I don't know, there's just... The characters are just getting so exponentially crazy that it's hard to do much against anything. Like, there's no wonder that old characters aren't gonna compete. It's because old characters have passives, like, lower stats by 30%. You know what I mean? Like, who's that gonna help? Whenever, like, you know, Escanor can't be stat lowered, so that immediately makes it obsolete. And then, I don't know, it's just, phew. Game's in a weird spot right now, I gotta say. Like, I'm not, like, upset about it or anything, but it's a little stale. I would be, I'd be lying if I wasn't saying, like, oh man, I'm having the most fun I've ever had in the game right now, boy. You know what I mean? So, I don't know, the game's gonna hit stale spots, you know, from time to time. Every time the meta shifts, basically, it's gonna end up being... Not the funnest time immediately after But, you know, hopefully they see what needs changing, what needs support. They come out with new characters. They sort of balance out the meta. And then hopefully everything kind of goes back to a little bit more normal. But I don't know. It's just a matter of time, more or less. Or who knows? Maybe some of these teams just end up getting left in the dust and they don't end up ever getting support, which it would be honestly really sad to see. So, having to deal with Melee with True Magic here might be kind of bad, but we'll hope he uses a single target, because if he uses the AoE here, I'm going to be in a real bad spot. So, unless this kills, grinding him down, it does. Nice. Honestly, I really like her mechanic. The fact that she hits like after she's done hitting is also really cool, which I thought that was really cool about Escanor too, but I don't know. Alrighty. Oh, we have basic. Is this the same? It's not the same guy, because I definitely out CC'd the last one because it was a bot. Let's see what happens here, because we're all defense lowered from Ludo. Obviously, Escanor's not. I don't think Escanor gets lowered by Ludo, because the match starts, his stats are what they are, and then nothing. I don't know. Like, no lower? Honestly, not 100% on that. Let's see the single target here. Oh boy, I guarantee this kills Roxy. Like, I'm willing to bet. She's so squishy, man. Like, I don't know if Deanne just needs a holy relic or what. So that way, like, maybe if Deanne had like a holy relic where she could just put taunt on like as soon as the match starts, so that way you can't immediately get one shot. Which a lot of people would probably hate that, but. And it would slow down PvP a little bit, of course, but at the same time, man, being able to lose a character at the very beginning of the match is so dumb sometimes. Like, it's bad. Like, it completely demoralizes you. You're like, all right, well, might as well move to the next match. Like, it forces a lot of forfeits, I think. I don't know, man. I'm in a weird mood today, I guess. Let me know. I don't know your thoughts on the whole situation, I guess. Let me know if you're. I know a lot of people. I put out a poll yesterday, I think it was, about like, oh, hey, like, how's everybody feel about Roxy at the moment? And a lot of people were like, eh, like, I mean, she's cool, but she's, pretty whale heavy. Well, this is basically gonna shut me down here. I think this is going to kill those two, yeah. Or, well, it didn't kill Arthur. AoE. And that's the game, folks. I don't know. It's just, I don't know if it's just the fact that I feel forced to use Roxy because she's, like, brand new and I want to make videos with her and I want to have fun with her. I think that she's a really fun character. But overall, it's just, it's not going as well as I was hoping it would have, you know what I mean? So, either way, I think next video we're probably gonna just try to do. I think everybody's overstressing like the fact that you need to have a human in this video in this team, which I definitely think having three humans helps, of course, because it's gonna make her pretty much guaranteed to crit. But the only thing that's really doing for you is giving you extra crit chance for her. Like, it's not doing anything else, if I'm not mistaken. I don't think it does anything else for you. So I think we're just going to try to replace the third slot with maybe something a little bit more supporty, or I don't know. Just, I don't think that it's really necessary to have three humans, because her crit chance is so high. Like, if she survives this right here, which I'm willing to bet she doesn't. Or, well, maybe not. If he uses the AoE first and then single targets her, she's dead, honestly. Let's see how it goes. Okay, he went for Escanor, actually. Actually kind of surprised by that, honestly. Let me check her crit chance, though. Because her crit chance should be, like, pretty high. Yeah, she's got 203 crit chance at the moment, which is pretty nuts. Can I get away with anything here? I'm assuming she has Tarmiel Link on. Yeah. Let me try to get rid of Margaret, I guess, so that way I can try to shut down some of his angel support here. That's not doing a whole lot. I don't know, just see, these teams have so much synergy. Like, it's crazy. The only thing I'm using here that's, like, supporty at all is Arthur. And then, of course, like, Deathpierce is helping me, but they can't be stat lowered. So, Deathpierce in this situation is actually useless. So, I don't know. There's just a lot of... A lot of bad units in the game now that the meta has been so power crept. It's actually crazy to think about. But, you know, I mean, obviously all games are going to power creep. It is what it is. Like, if you want new characters to be exciting and interesting, obviously they have to be better than the last character. Or else no one's going to summon there. I already got a character that does something in this field. So, like, why bother, you know? And that's understandable. I get that. But... Doesn't make it very healthy for the game, you know? Well, this is unfortunate. I really don't know that I can do much about this. So, I don't know, man. Like, if you're not running, like, the big meta stuff right now, it's gonna be a real, real iffy win. Can this even kill? No. Man. I highly doubt we survive this. Yeah, he's not. I wish he was dumb enough to lose his ultimate move gauge by attacking first, but... Oh. Yeah. Arthur surprisingly survives that, which is awesome. But, yeah. Either way, that's pretty much going to be it for me today. I don't know. Don't know what else to say. I'll mess around with some more stuff, I'm sure, but just know... I don't know. It is what it is. I'm getting kind of sick of Roxy already. She's been up for like 2 days as I'm recording this. So, yeah. See you guys later.